The European Investment Bank is at the same time a European institution, and it is a bank, which makes it quite unusual. The EIB is here to make a difference for Europeans, for the European people. That is, I think, the first and main objective. It is a unique institution that doesn't cost any money to the European budget and to the, at the end of the day, to the European taxpayer. We borrow money on the market in conditions that are good, and we are able to then lend money, and we lend this money without making a profit. We are managed by a board of directors that meet basically every month and take decision on the lending operations that we make. In order to select a project, we make sure that they are within the European Union policy. We make sure that the financial conditions are good for the people who borrow. But basically, we calculate what we call value added, which is actually the social and economic return of the project. That what will it bring to the population that would not exist without us. Recently we have financed, for instance, a wonderful project in Scotland financing the construction of schools.
In all of the schools, there has been a tremendous attention to the educational needs of the youngsters for whom these buildings are being designed. This is a main thoroughfare within this school. As you can see, beautifully wide corridors. All of the schools are well equipped as far as IT is concerned. Interactive whiteboard here. Everything's been thought through for people with any form of disability. This is a public private partnership venture. Once the decision had been taken by the European Investment Bank, they were extremely helpful when we got to the stage of actually having a partner on board. So by the time that we actually got to the final negotiations on the contract, we had on the table a project covering 11 schools with a very, very wide range of additional facilities, which we almost undoubtedly wouldn't have been able to afford had it not been for the fact that there was this involvement from the EIB.
Our projects are not very remote from everyday life. They are here for each citizen to benefit from them. We support small and medium-sized enterprises in many ways. One I could mention is also we do microcredit. We provide money to some microfinance specialists who then can do it better than we do, but without us they would not have the same type of financing.
Microcredit is not important as such. What is important is access to money, access to decision making, and access to autonomy.
What we get from the EIB is €1 million. If you distribute it in something like €200, the average loan, by giving them €200 or €300, there's something which sparkles in them, and they start their business, and you have the feeling that these women were born entrepreneurs and they just need this sparkling money, this seed money.
But now that we are working all over Tunisia, we have 50 branches all over the country. I tell women, when you come to ANDA, you ask for a loan, you should be very proud because you are paying, you are asking for a service and you are paying for it. You are not begging.
I'm working with my mom in a workshop with a disabled person in handcraft. We have a loan from INDA, it's a microfinance enterprise. She gives us and help us to have money to produce and to develop our work. These women are Benet Baballa, the ladies of the heaven. They're happy because they have the chance to work.
We have for any infrastructure project an environment impact assessment. We can measure the impact, and this is one of the basis on which the board of directors will decide to finance or not to finance a project. We have projects that support specifically the environment. One of them I could mention is the Aquanet project in Poland.
The main task of Aquanet here in Poznan is to provide about 240,000 cubic meters of quality water to about 850,000 people. The process of the water treatment starts here. We take 20% of the water from the Warta River and about 80% of the water from the groundwater wells, which are situated along the river.
20 years ago, it was completely incomparable. The people which are living here still remember the Warta River, which was unbelievably polluted. Present technology is to reducing the chemicals, and from the sludge we are producing the energy. Thus everything looks more easy and more environmental. They gave us a loan for the $500 million for investments, which means more than 120 million euro. The AIB, they are a bit more flexible than a normal bank is. The loan is valid for 26 years, which is very convenient for us.
The bank is investing massively in research and technology and innovation. We have a priority that we call actually priority for the knowledge economy, which is most certainly in Europe the economy of the future. We have very advanced research that we have been financing, for instance, in Austria.
ABL is in the business to develop powertrain systems and to produce and develop instruments and systems for engine and vehicle testing. ABL focuses on reducing emissions and reduces the costs in the development of engines. We are sure that with our activities, we contribute a small part to improve the efficiency in mobility and also to improve and taking care of the worldwide climate. We have more than 4,300 employees. We are privately owned, and we are the world largest producer and development company in this business. Our customers is the worldwide automotive industry, the car producers all over the world. They come to us and ask us to develop engines for them.
AVL is one of the most research-intensive engineering companies in Europe in the automotive industry. With this operation, the bank fulfills one of its key objectives, which is to support research, development and innovation. In addition to that, the bank also contributes to environmental objectives within the European Union.